River deltas, a beautiful landform where the river flows into the sea. Home to fertile soil and unique biodiversity. Deltas are among the most productive ecosystems on Earth. They support the lives and livelihoods of 500 million people. These people are more at risk now, with increasing pressure from population growth, industrialization, and a rapidly changing climate. It is more important than ever that these valuable ecosystems and vulnerable communities are made more resilient to escalating risks. Even though marginalized people are the first to be affected by climate-induced shifting weather patterns, droughts, floods, and storms, their voices are often ignored in the planning process. Does involving them result in local adaptation measures that are more favorable to them? And can nature-based solutions increase the resilience of communities and ecosystems in delta regions across the world? Let's find out.
National initiatives of long-term integrated planning with a dedicated and assured budget can address the challenges people face and increase their resilience. All it needs is political will and commitment to implement proven solutions.
One of the solutions at work is in Bangladesh, which has the world's largest river delta.
The implementation of key projects such as rehabilitation of embankments and drainage infrastructure, protection of riverbanks from erosion, community-based early warning systems, social forestry, and nature-based solutions will ease the vulnerability of the Delta population and help Bangladesh in its path of progress towards prosperity.
Beira, the second largest city in Mozambique, has shown political will and commitment in improving the climate resilience of its Delta population.
We work very hard to bring investment to Beira for climate change adaptation. After devastation of Cyclone Idai in 2019, we succeeded in bringing our partners together and mobilized $115 million in climate adaptation infrastructure, mostly for coastal protection and drainage.
Climate change adaptation is a long-term process, and Delta countries need all the financial support to design and implement country-specific plans. Immediate action will result in faster, increased resilience.
Climate change hits vulnerable communities first and hardest. How can we make sure that the adaptation measures are tailored to their needs?
The voices of local communities need to be heard while developing solutions and responses. They need to be empowered to participate and express themselves and contribute to these planning processes. Communities need not only the finance to deal with climate impacts, but also the power to decide how these funds are used. Adaptation action must be designed by communities in ways that are effective for them, not based on some external artificial silos of policy or finance.
Traditional community knowledge acknowledges the importance of nature, but sometimes communities have no choice and ignore environmental concerns when their immediate need is feeding their families.
Orang tua kami telah mengingatkan bahwa kami harus melindungi hutan mangrove dan tidak menebanginya untuk dijadikan tambak. Sekarang dengan hilangnya sebagian besar mangrove, laut telah menyapu tanggul-tanggul tambak kami hingga masuk ke daratan sekitar 1 mil dan desa telah kehilangan 25 baris tambaknya.
In Indonesia, adaptation works are being implemented to protect the eroding coastline. The key to this process is the participation of local communities and incentives for sustainable livelihoods, including stakeholders and communities, is important everywhere, even in high-income countries. In the Netherlands, a low-lying country which is vulnerable to flooding from rivers and sea, adaptation planning involves extensive public consultation.
The Dutch Delta Programme sets out plans to protect the country from flooding, mitigate the impacts of extreme weather events, and secure freshwater supply. The government recognizes the importance of spatial planning in adaptation measures and hence incorporates it in policy planning and implementation. The Dutch Delta Programme is unique because of the extensive community consultation and stakeholder participation that includes central government, municipalities, water authorities, and the public. It places us in the Netherlands in a strong position when it comes to adapting to rapidly changing circumstances in our urbanized delta.
With Bihar, it was with the
government. Plans are unlikely to target climate change impacts effectively unless they heed the voices of those whose lives and livelihoods are at stake.
The world's river deltas are facing the consequences of human actions. Deltas are sinking due to excessive groundwater extraction and shrinking due to upstream dams retaining the sediments, making them increasingly vulnerable to flooding from rivers and ocean storms, and putting hundreds of millions of people at risk.
We need to tackle the systemic threats in a systemic way. Wicked problems demand a holistic, inclusive, and future-proof approach. Collaborative approach of working together with partners to develop, fund and implement integrated and nature-based solutions is the best way forward.
Local capacity, an enabling environment, and institutional collaboration are key to upscaling these nature-based solutions to entire deltas. Paraná Delta in Argentina is a case in point.
Here in Argentina, in the Paraná Delta, it is clear the added value and the trade-offs of nature-based solutions. This approach, scaled for large river delta system, could improve the means of development, production, and city growth towards a more sustainable model. That change would attract innovative projects and investments to create benefits for future generations.
Nature-based solutions can contribute to disaster risk reduction, build resilient cities, improve water management, and contribute to food security, as demonstrated in Vietnam.
We need to provide for livelihood and use nature-based solutions to achieve both short-term and long-term benefits. For example, in Mekong Delta's Kamau province, we promote ecological stream farming and mangrove restoration and protection. Mangrove bring long-term benefits including storm protection, reduction of coastal erosion and carbon sequestration. Ecological farming has very minimal impact on the environment and it provides economic incentive for farmers.
There is another innovative approach to improve climate and urban resilience. Floating development.
Amphibious and floating houses, farms or gardens are proved to be effective and future-proof solutions with many benefits, such as adaptation to the sea level rise and creating new values underwater.
Naturecentric solutions also need to be country-specific, as showcased in the Netherlands.
We've realized the importance of having nature and natural resources at the center of our existence. As a result, in the Netherlands, we're giving our rivers more space to flow. We need to learn to work with nature and not against it. We must revisit some of our traditional approaches and take into account local and traditional wisdom.
These stories show us that climate change impact in deltas is too real and needs immediate action. But they also show us that community participation brings out the most effective and sustainable solutions. When we plan integrated, environment-friendly solutions, considering local communities' wisdom, our deltas will certainly become sustainable and life-sustaining.